DIG Roopa, who exposed the irregularities in the Bengaluru prison in her report, has now been served a 50 crore rupees defamation suit. Yes, you heard it right. It's a 50 crore rupees defamation suit. The notice has been served by DGP HN Satyanarayan Rao, who DIG Roopa accused of taking 2 crore rupees bribe to grant special privileges to AIDMK General Secretary Sasikala in prison. The 50 crore defamatory notice alleges Roopa's allegations have tarnished the image of the former DGP prisons. The notice argues Roopa could take pictures elsewhere on the prison premises, but not in Sasikala's cell, as no special privileges have been provided to Sasikala. Remember, the Karnataka government had shunted out DIG Roopa on July 17th. Well, after being served with a legal notice by DIG Prisons HN Satyanarayan Rao, now DIG Roopa has strongly reacted to the 50 crore rupees defamation case filed against her.
Satyanarayan Rao has sent you a notice, and that is legal notice of defamation case of 50 crores. How do you react to this now?
See, I've done my duty, and there is a confessional statement of one Mr. Prakash with the Delhi police in EC bribery case, in which he has mentioned that he has acted as an agent, arranged the meeting between one Mr. Mallikarjun and Ms. Shashikala, and that he knows jail officials. So this agent kind of behavior is, I think, is a lead from where the investigation has to take forward, the same lead, and look into the matter. And there is also a complaint with the ACB, Anti-Corruption Bureau.
This is filed by a lawyer?
Of the state government, yes. Filed by somebody on the bribery charges. So that can be taken forward with this lead.
But how do you take this defamation notice? Will you be replying to the defamation notice that Mr. Rao has given?
No, as per this one, I have done my duty, and I wouldn't like to react any further on this.
But also one question I'd like to ask you at this time. No, at this time is that how the entire thing is that the report that you have submitted, I spoke to the Chief Minister, Mr. Siddaramaiah. He said the probe will continue, but based on that, they will also take a call on it. So he says that only based on your report, they can't take a call. How do you look at that?
I have no comments to make. I have submitted my report.
And Mr. Satyanarayan Rao said that Shashikala is not getting any privileges there. The bribery case is completely out. It's not necessary to even make him, maligning him, and that is why the defamation case, that she's got no privileges. Why take pictures of every other cell, but not her cell?
Well, see, my I don't want to discuss any further on this. My report was an internal report. I was not ordered any inquiry to be conducted by, I was not appointed as an inquiry officer by government or anyone. It was an internal report given to him, and sadly he refuted the charges. He should have said, okay, I'll look into this, and taken it forward and cleared all those things. And the photos are there, evidence is there.
That is what he's saying. Why take photos not of any other cell, but not of her cell, only to prove that possibly.
I don't know what he has told, but those things are wrong. Evidence is there for everything. And at this juncture, only I can say this. And generally, you know, when an officer gives a report, it has to be taken seriously. And it is generally taken seriously every time when a superintendent of police reports on a situation, etc.
All right, Rohini, my colleague is now joining me on the phone line for more on this. Rohini, once again, DIG Roopa sticking to her stand, saying that she still is, sticking by the report that she had sent. Now, after this defamation suit, she's been also shunted out by the government. Is there a sense that she's been isolated and being victimized in this?
Well, there's no sense of being isolated as of now, but what we've seen is the government has said that we will wait for the report, the complete probe that is being conducted by a former IAS officer, and then we'll take a stand. But clearly the Chief Minister also saying that they will not spare anybody who they find in the report would be corrupt or have violated any rules. But here, DIG Roopa also feels that her report that she submitted was dismissed by her senior rather than taking cognizance and saying that some kind of action would be taken. Now, that is what has hurt her more. And also, she said that there was no need for him to defend himself. Rather, when a police officer of her level comes and says that there are some discrepancies, there are some violations, he could have actually conducted a probe or ordered a probe. And she goes on to say that she was not given any inquiry or the responsibility of inquiring, but as a post, as IG Prisons when she was there, she did what she thought was right, and that is why she's sticking to her guns and saying, as an officer, I have as of now filed my report and I have enough evidence. But clearly, Satyanarayan Rao, with his 50 crore defamation suit that he's filed against her, is trying to make a point. But we should also remember that at the end of this month, on the 31st, Satyanarayan Rao also will be retiring. So before that, he would definitely want to clear his name before he leaves the force.
Thank you so much, Rohini, for joining us with all those details.